Good afternoon, guys. I just woke up. I think it's is it afternoon? Yes. But yeah, guys, there's a lot that's gonna happen in this vlog, but we're just having like a 5 days off vlog, a weekly vlog, because I also have to film a weekend vlog this weekend because a lot, like I said, is gonna happen. So anyways, good afternoon, or rather good and afternoon morning. Afternoon slash doesn't make sense. But anyways, I just got out of bed because I was recovering from last week, guys. I was recovering and now I'm officially up. But yeah, let's do the bed. I need to look for my tripod somewhere. I need to look for my tripod, and I also need to go fetch the things in the garage of last week's picnic, like my ring light, my throws, the dishes that we've used. I need to also wash those, and we're going to unbraid my hair finally today because, guys, it's about time. Like, yesterday was a whole month of me keeping these braids in, so I hope my hair has grown a little. But y'all, let's get our day started. Oh, please don't judge me. Please don't judge me.
Suppress my feelings, 'cause I know what's best for me. Feel short of confidence, my hands begin to shake. I thought I knew you, but I barely knew your name. Awesome.
Okay, guys, gonna quickly change from my PJs into like something I can wear for now so I can be comfortable cleaning and whatever. Guys, I have to tell you guys a story, so please remind me of that. But like, you know, on the last vlog, if you watch my last vlog, you know that I was sleeping at my sister's house. So these are like my dirty laundry that I need to wash, but during the week, not now though, because it is cold outside, it's windy. It's, I don't know what's the thing with July and August where it gets so windy and cold, but I'm gonna take out the things that I am gonna wash and put it in the basket and wear like my homeware, my comfy homeware, because I still need to bath, so I can just wear those. And yeah, that's that.
Saying what you mean. Suppress my feelings, 'cause I know what's best for me. Feel short of confidence, my hands begin to shake. I thought I knew you. Awesome. Stuck to your teeth, you got everything. porcelain stuck to your teeth. You got porcelain under your skin, and I'm all for it again and again and again. For someone you don't even know what you could have done to tell you the truth. I love porcelain. You put down the phone, you've nowhere to go. Get back on the road. Yeah, it's so thank you. care if I got much at all here in this small town. Cause in the end we're all buried deep inside the same hole in the ground.
Make food. I was on a call with my man, so let's eat something. It's 2 o'clock now, so I'm hungry. Okay, I have not eaten breakfast, I have not eaten lunch, so let's find something to eat in the fridge and eat. And it's extremely cold.
So pretty, noticed in the postcards from the city. I've been walking downtown every day. In spite of this, I always try to fit in. When they consume my head, I hate this feeling. I wanna be a fairy girl and not a villain. I hate the city, but I stay for you. My love's so pretty, and I always knew from the day we met I'll be with you. The first time you said that you love me too. Mess without you, I'm hollowed out. So I packed my things and we moved down south. Shared a room in a foreign house. This will take some time, but it's what it's all about.
I'm gonna eat now. Gonna show you my food. Guys, when it comes to food, I am the kingpin of food. We have bratwurst, pork meat, cow meat, I think, lasagna. Guys, it's just and salads and my bread. So lemon tea. The way it's so cold, yo, it's so windy, it feels like August. But I'm gonna eat and watch a vlog.
Found the one, you should never give her up. I think it's the way life changes when in love, yeah. I surround my soul with the positivity. That's why I don't worry about the things that I don't see, yeah. These days I don't worry about much. I think we should have some more fun. I still dream about the days when we were young. I'll take a hit and still finish and run, yeah, yeah. Too far away from our hearts, yeah, yeah. The ones we keep close, we should never let go. So tell me who you love, baby. Take a moment to unwind, fix yourself and realign yourself with the world, baby. Breathe slow, baby.
Hey loves, today is Tuesday. Yesterday I did not continue vlogging because while I was washing dishes, my girlfriend called me to go and chill and drink and hang out because she's leaving today to go to Joburg. So Reba, bestie, if you're watching this, thank you so much for yesterday and I love you. But we went to go and enjoy yesterday. We went out and we were drinking and like not going out, like we just went to book a guest house as the girls, and we were like I think 8, and we had bought bottles of Hennessy and we were playing truth or dare, and it was just very very nice. I really did enjoy. And yeah, today, that's why you guys see my hair still like this. We have to take this hair down, guys. We literally have to take this hair down. It's just today I woke up being feeling bothered, you know, like I don't know if it's because I'm on my time, but I'm just, guys, I'm emotionally I'm not okay, you know. I feel down, I feel disappointed, I feel betrayed, I feel used, I feel lied onto. Like, it's just a lot of things that have been happening in my life. It's just, you know, when you just let go of, oh, am I swallowing or what's this? Oh, there's nothing. It's me being delusional. But when you just let go of certain things and you just, those things, they just keep attacking you for no reason. So I am disappointed because it happens to you when you're not like when you least expect it, and it always happens because of the people you thought you could convey it in or the people you thought you could trust. And it's just these red flags. But I'm very happy that sometimes God gets to reveal certain people in your life. And you know, like, if something happens once and fine, okay, cool, you let it slide, but then when it happens for the second time, you must know, like, you have to limit and distance yourself from certain people. Like, not saying that you must hate them or, you know, whatever, but you just know your place when it comes to them with certain things. Like, when you speak about certain things to them, you know, like, where to limit yourself. And when you do certain things, you have to know, like, who to include and exclude. So I just felt like I've came to a point where I've grew physically, spiritually, I've grew, and I just know, like, where to have an end, like, where to have a stop and what to expect. And I've learned that have no expectations, have no disappointments. So yeah, that's what I've learned. And yeah, I just wanted to, like, vent with you guys, because so far you guys have been my safe space. And I'm not gonna go into details about what's happening in my life, but I just feel like it's just those, one of those things that you just, as a person, you go through because God wants you to go through them, and he makes you go through certain things for a reason. And there's literally nothing wrong with you. It's the same people that makes you think there's something wrong with you, is because they're placing the insecurities of what they feel about themselves and about what they go, what they live on their base day-to-day life, and they're just trying to paint you as a bad person. It's how they feel about themselves, and they want you to feel the things that they feel to make themselves feel better, if it makes sense. So you should not let someone just, you know, try and make you feel otherwise or whatever, because they have insecurities themselves and it's what they are going through. So, like, if someone would call you crazy or mad or stupid, it's them being the same and they're trying to implant the insecurities on you. So that's what I've also learned. So it's not because when people say you're crazy, you are crazy. You're not crazy. You're heavenly anointed by God. It's them being crazy and stupid that they are trying to blame you for their craziness and their stupidity. So yeah, that's all I needed to say, guys. I'm going to undo my hair and then I'm going to talk to you guys, because there's a story time that I need to tell you guys about as well that happened on the last vlog. So yeah, I'll see you guys when I am done journaling, because I just feel like I haven't done journaling in a long time, and I need to journal and write a diary. So yeah, I got back from the shop because I needed to do coffee. Remember I told you guys I wanted to do coffee, and oof, we didn't have. So I went to go buy sugar for my room, so I can never run out of sugar when I need, because I drink tea or coffee a lot. And I bought myself some bread, because I know I don't eat pap. Because I always make pap. And then I bought some eggs for now, because we don't have eggs too. And I bought myself 5 roses tea. And Mazimba and 100 rand airtime because I need airtime. I don't have data, so I'm gonna journal. I write, this is my church book, like this is where I write all my affirmations and my Bible verses and stuff. And then at the back is where I write my journal, my workout schedules and stuff like that. And then in front is where I write the biblical things, the verses, the meditation and everything. To write my diary, because I told you guys, like I said, I've been feeling off. And I just need to figure out literally what I want before anything. So I like to also, a way of healing is when I am like writing down diary, when I'm journaling, and that's also my meditation, how I get to relax and know that I have, like, it also will help me when I look back and I would actually see, like, yo, girl, you went through this, you're actually stronger than you think you are. And if you could go through this, you can go through this. So it's just like a reminder of what you went through, where you're going and where you came from. And it's just God at the end of the day, you know. So I'm going to write it down in my book and we're gonna undo this hair, guys, because it's damn time. I know I'm getting paid month end, but I know God is gonna make a way of me getting my hair braided. I declined the creed that this weekend I'm gonna get my hair braided, so we'll see about that. You know, speak it, ask, you shall receive. Let's speak it. I don't have money, guys. I'm literally telling you guys, I don't have money, but I'm gonna have money by the end of this week. And by the end of this week, my hair is going to be braided into a new style. Please hold me to that, okay?
So let go, baby.
I'm left with a few at the back, you gonna see. So I'm gonna make food because I have not eaten the whole day and it's 5:30. The only thing I drank was tea. That's the only thing I had. Other than that, I haven't had like food or anything, you know. So I need to eat. I'm gonna finish this off when I am done eating, because It's gonna take me a few minutes to complete my full hair, but we're getting there, as you guys can see. It's the hairline for me, doll, it's gone. I'm gonna give my hair a break, guys. Yeah, I need to give my hair a break. A break. Yo, yo, yo. Achong. If I were to do my hair, I'm gonna do it on Thursday. Or is a 2 days break not enough, guys? Anyway, yeah, let's go make food because I'm hungry. Eggs and toasted bread. And I'm gonna make lemon tea. I promise you all, I am not on a diet, okay? I'm gonna be though. Because every time I tell you guys I'm drinking lemon tea, so. We're not on a diet yet. I cut my bread. It almost fell. I thought it was starting to pour. I'm like, what? But if you know me, you know I love me some rain, honey. Hey girl, it's me again. And I'm drinking gin and dry lemon. My sister gave me this and actually very nice. We're gonna tackle this hair. I'm not in the mood, but we almost there, so yeah.
rag top, chrome pipes, flow lights out of sight. Long way, sold in, say it again, sold in. Make that money, throw it in. Booty bouncing, gone ahead. Rolls Royce, Lamborghini, Blue Medina, always be the rag top, chrome pipes, flow lights out of sight. Long way, sold in, say it again, sold in. Make that money, throw it in. Booty bouncing, gone ahead. Rolls Royce, Lamborghini, Blue Medina, always be the rag top, chrome pipes, flow lights out of sight. Long way, sold in.
Like when you make a huge bun, be heavy and uncomfortable, especially at night. Yeah, I must do blow out. I must do not blow out, like sock press, and see how long my hair is. That sounds like a good idea. But do we have the money for it right now? Absolutely not. Because I know after that, we're gonna have to braid again. So no. No, thank you. Guys, I need to tell you guys a story time. Quick story time. And the last vlog. If you did not watch the last vlog, please go back and come back to this one. Thank you. So I spent the weekend at my sister's house and everything was nice and fun because they did a braai. And you guys saw, I went crazy. They like, I'm talking about, they made me smoke weed. Okay, I should stop blaming people because I have the free will of doing whatever I want to do with my life, and if I feel like I want to smoke weed, I'll smoke weed regardless of people trying to influence me or not. At the end of the day, you girl have the final say. So we're drinking and buying and having fun. Long story short, my best friend came over because she's leaving. I think she left today or she's leaving tomorrow. But I spent the weekend with her. She came to my sister's house. We were having fun. We were vibing. Fine. Suddenly, this girl is like, let's go out. And I'm like, girl, it's 2 a.m. And no, because my boyfriend is going to be complaining, like, where are we going at 2 a.m.? And mind you, like, our clubs, there's a club here in Valcom at Sidebar. Like, it doesn't close. It closes in the morning, like, around 7 or 8 a.m. in the morning. Because I know, like, clubs in Joburg, they close at 2. So he was definitely going to complain. He was going to think I'm lying to him because he's used to clubs in Joburg. Because he stays in Joburg and he's used to clubs that closes at 2. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to try and call him and find out. And he anyway said no. Me trying to be sneaky, I was like, okay, cool. Let me go dress my white buffer jacket. And we're gonna go out. Long story short, we were drinking shot at my sister's house, shots after shots after shots after shots after shots with her friends, my brother's girlfriends, and whatever. Fine. I went to the bathroom and we're literally waiting for the guy. It was one of her guy friends, and we're literally waiting for the guy, and I was like, let me go take a pee. But something kept saying, don't go to the bathroom, don't go to. Guys, when I literally tell you that you always have to listen to your inner voice, something kept saying to me, do not go to the bathroom. Girl, did I not go to the bathroom? I went to the bathroom. Mind you, I have a bodysuit on, so I have to take out my bomber jacket and I put it on the floor. I took off my bodysuit. I sat on the toilet to pee. And as I was peeing, my brother's girlfriend came rushed into the toilet and she literally vomited on me. She literally threw up on me. I'm talking about my hair was full of... Me thinking about it, my hair was full of vomit. My bodysuit, mind you, my white jacket, my sneakers, everything, I was covered in vomit. And I was like, yeah, I'm not going out, because I feel like also it was a punishment of, okay, I'm gonna do it behind my boyfriend's back and he's not gonna know, and I'm just gonna go ahead and go out anyways. Girl, did God not say, girl, you do not listen the first time I spoke and I said don't go to the bathroom? And secondly, when I'm giving you signs not to go out, you busy wanting to go out. So no, you're not going out. And here I was, covered in vomit. Was I not pissed and angry? Guys, to think when someone vomits on you and all the food that they ate and the previous food and the drinks and the alcohol and whatever they were consuming goes all on you. Oof. I was pissed, okay? So yeah, that's the little story I wanted to tell you guys. Guys, you know I'll be telling you guys these funny stories, and like you guys are my diaries. I'll be telling you like back to back stories, like hot lit topics. And girl, this one, I must say it's one of the top two, because what? I never had someone throwing up on me my whole life. Like, what? Girl, you were. So yeah, I love that was so embarrassing. I felt embarrassed for her because she kept apologizing, as angry as I was, and I was like trying to be cool, and she was like, I'm sorry, I will wash your jacket, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. And I was like, it's cool. I was pissed, but I was like, okay, cool, because you have to learn how to forgive people, right? Because God says if people wronged you you have to forgive them 7 times 77, so which is like 4,000 times. Do the maths. I don't know, somewhere there. Am I right? Am I wrong? I don't know. But the point is, you have to forgive others so that God can forgive you. So yeah, that's the story, guys. I'm going to sleep now. I'm gonna sleep early because I also have to edit a vlog. So I'm gonna close the curtains, do the bed, all of those night routine stuff that I did on the other vlogs. I'm not gonna repeat it again, no. So I guess I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.
Lamborghini, blue Medina, always beaming, rag top, chrome pipes, blue lights, out of sight, long way, sold in, say it again, sold in, make that money, throw it in, booty bouncing, go ahead, Rolls Royce, Lamborghini, blue Medina, always beaming, rag top, chrome pipes, blue lights, out of sight, long way, sold in, say it again, sold in, make that money, throw it in, and don't come on, come on. Rolls Royce, Lamborghini, blue Medina, always beaming, rag top, chrome pipes, blue lights, out of sight, long way, sold in, say it again, sold in, make that money, throw it in, booty bouncing, don't come on, come on. Rolls Royce, Lamborghini, blue Medina, always beaming, rag top, chrome pipes, blue lights, out of sight, long way, sold in, say it again, sold in.
lights out of sight. So thin, say it again, so thin. Make that money, throw it in. Booty bouncing, gone.
Broke my power bank. Great.
Thursday. Yesterday I did not vlog because I was in pain and I was on my period, and yesterday was Wednesday, today is Thursday, and there was nothing to do yesterday. So we're gonna read the Bible. Today I have to wash my hair because what is this? I have to wash my hair. We have to go take out money at the bank, buy pads because I ran out. I have one left, so that's how heavy I've been bleeding. Buy bread, eggs, and soap to wash my clothes because tomorrow I'm planning to clean this room, wash clothes and all of those. But that is going to be on the next vlog because I'm going to end this vlog today and do a weekend vlog because I have not vlogged a weekend vlog. But stay tuned for that vlog because we're going to be doing exciting things on that vlog. So yeah. And also guys, please remind me, month end we are buying curtains. This thing of putting throws there to block the light is not cute, okay? We are buying curtains month end. Remind me, please. So yeah, those are the things that I'm gonna be doing today. So I almost swallowed you guys in. Let's read Bible, please, because feel like I'm procrastinating and I am just not in the mood of doing anything. I just feel like jumping back to bed. My Bible did not have Proverbs 19 verse 2, and it says, two desires without knowledge is not good, and whoever makes haste with his feet misses his way too. So please go check that out. I need to wash my hair because it's a mess, and I'm gonna wash it in here. Thank you.
je cherche un homme, un homme, un homme, un Pierre Paul, un Jacques, un Tom.
And I was washing dishes, as you saw, and I also washed my hair. I need to hair dry it and we're gonna head out. Also, I did not apply any face cream on my face because I was washing my hair and I didn't want like the water that I was gonna get on my face to wash off the product that I had applied. So I was like, after washing my hair, I'll just put on my face lotion, my face product. One thing I don't like being on your period as a girl, not only do you get pains, but you get facial breakouts, and it's not cute. I have breakouts on my face. I don't know if you guys will notice on the camera, because sometimes the camera be deceiving you all, but I have a breakout here, and I have a breakout here, and I have like few breakouts here. I don't know if you guys can see there, but yeah, what I'm trying to say is that the camera doesn't always show like full details, you know? So yeah, I have quite a few breakouts because of my periods, and it's not cute. Hopefully tomorrow I'll be done with it, because today's day 3. And tomorrow's day 4. And normally I finish on day 3 or day 4. So hopefully tomorrow I'll be out and about. But I'm anyways going to go buy them, because I'm gonna need one for tonight. Because I had one in the morning, I have now one in the afternoon, and I'm gonna need one for tonight. Ladies, if you don't change your pads when you're on your periods, I'm judging you. I am literally judging you. I try not to apply as much heat on my hair anymore. So I don't know if I want to like straightener it or just leave it like this and then go get it braided tomorrow. I literally need to consider giving my hair a break, guys, because what is this? Yo! I need to give my hair a break. And I just cannot not sit with my hair like this and not get it braided, because what am I gonna do with it like this? And it's the mentality I have to let go. Like, you can stay with your hair like this, it's fine. You don't have to always get your hair braided. But being a black child, yeah, that's all I'm gonna say. Let's go hair dry my hair. I can't sing, I know. Please save yourself from the embarrassment, guys. I need a hair cloth. I need this because I'm not going to tie my hair. My hair literally needs a break. My hair has been in a bun from Tuesday, and today is Thursday. And tell me why I did not clean this room, because I normally clean it on Thursday. But I'll clean it tomorrow. But that means I have to wash laundry today with you all. And then on the next vlog, then I'll clean it with you all. Hectic. And also tell me, guys, what videos you guys would like to see. What kind of videos you guys like to see. I'm going to do like a sit down video on Saturday. I don't want to always give you guys vlogs, you know. So tell me what videos you guys would want to see and give me ideas of things I need to talk about when it comes to having vlogs or whatever. Let's go, because I'm gonna be dragging it. Thank you. guys, we need to make fast. We need to sprint to the store. We are ready. Sneakers, leggings, and jersey. Is this a jersey? Yes. I don't know. Let's go. Yo guys, one thing about me, I will always come out when it is, the stores are about to close, always, and I must leave that habit. It's not a good habit. I got pads, and also I need a small soap. I doubt they have the Big Mac, which is 22 rand. Does Mac wash properly, guys? I think we should get it. Hold on. Oh guys, the things I do for you. I'm holding everything in one hand. We're getting this. But I want it like the small one. I don't know how I feel about this. Oh guys, look at the noodles. It's 20 rand for Should we buy it? Wait, hold on. Let me just do my calculations quickly. I'm in Checkers. We got bread because I'm also looking for eggs, but the prices are ridiculous. Like, what? I just got home. I'm gonna show you guys the things that I got. Guys, look how dark it is. Okay, it's not dark, but like I wanted to do laundry with you guys, so please don't call me lazy because I'll do it on the next vlog with you guys, I promise. But the things I got from cosmetics is niggas and men giving into zami kai futu men a posh panda manager. Kotex, I don't compromise when it comes to pads. Noodles, I got Eze Durban Curry flavor. I've heard a lot about Durban Curry, so which must be good. And then I got soap to wash my clothes. And then from Checkers, I got eggs, 6 eggs. Guys, who knows this? This is so old school. But I got the Mazimba, guys. Like, I like Doritos, don't get me wrong. Those fancy chips and whatever. But I'm one to get the Mazimba atelwang, right? And I just feel like this is the perfect example for Mazimba atelwang. And then I also got bread. So I'm gonna put these away and we're gonna make something to eat, because I have not eaten this whole day. I must have just took it as fasting, but I haven't been praying in between, but it's definitely a fast. And I'm still not hungry, hey? But I'm gonna eat because my boyfriend was shouting at me saying that I must eat, because he's saying I'm losing a lot of blood, which he's definitely right. Like, I'm on my periods, I'm losing blood, so I must eat. Okay, toasted bread, eggs, lemon tea. I'm running out of my lemon juice. Guys. Please send help. Immediately. I'm done bathing, done doing my night routine. I also need to do a night routine with you guys sometime soon, so stay tuned for that, so that you guys can see the things that I do at night. Also a morning routine as well, so you guys can see the things that I do in the morning as well. So I'm gonna close off this vlog. I hope you guys did enjoy, and if you did, please do give this video a big thumbs up. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already, and as always, my boos, I love you guys super much, and I'll see you guys on my next little video. Love you guys, peace. I'm